Hi everyone, it's Matt from Greatness Every Day, and in this video, I'm going to give you a method, a process that you can use right away to have better quality conversations. But first, I want to ask, if you're not subscribed to our channel, please go down and hit the subscribe button to find out when more content related to personal development, health, and wealth comes out. I would really appreciate that. And we're going to get into our topic today by talking about conversations and how you can start doing something right away that's really easy to have better quality ones. So with that, conversations are things that we all do regardless of where we live, regardless of where we work, and we do them for a variety of different reasons. It could be to improve your relationship with somebody, family, friends, loved one. It could be to close a deal at business or something related to your profession, or a variety of other reasons. We have conversations every single day, and it's really important that our conversations allow us to communicate what we're trying to, and at the same time, it gives the other people an opportunity to learn what we're about, what we like, just tell them essentially who we are. So conversation and that skill is very important. And what I'm going to do here is give you a method and give you a strategy that you can use when you're meeting somebody for the first time, or if you're following up with somebody for a variety of different reasons, and you can start using it right away to have better quality conversations. So it's called the Ford method. It's an acronym. The very first thing, the F, stands for family. Whether you know somebody or you're meeting them for the first time in any setting, and you're just kind of having that small talk, because we have people in our lives that are great at small talk, but these strategies and this acronym is going to help you really kind of step into that arena, let's say, if you're not comfortable doing this. So the F stands for family. You are able to ask somebody, how's your family? Are you married? Do you have any kids? And you're able to get a nice icebreaker into learning a little bit about the person that you're talking to, and reciprocate that, and you're able to share and communicate a little bit about yourself too. And family is something that you typically start a conversation with, because it's really easy. It's something that a lot of people typically like to talk about. It's not very hard. You can kind of step into it lightly, and then as you're going through the conversation, if you like what you're talking about, if the other person is into the conversation as well, you can take that next step into what we say is the O in that Ford method. And the O stands for occupation. And a lot of people like to talk about what they do. Trust me, I'm a teacher. Teachers, you get a bunch of us in the same room, we always talk about teaching. It's a blessing and a curse in some ways. But for occupation, you're able to say, so what do you do for work? Or you're able to bounce other ideas, find similar interests. Maybe you know your brother or sister that works in the same industry as this person. You're able to establish more connections. And really, that's what communication is about, and having good conversation. Being able to listen actively to the other person, establish connections. And once you identify things that you have related to family, or maybe even occupation in common with somebody, you're able to create a bond there. So those are the first two. The third one, the R, is recreation. What do you like to do for fun? Is something that you are asking somebody, what is something that you like to do? So it's not a hard question. It could be as simple as just saying, hey, so outside of work, outside of spending time with your family, what do you like to do in your spare time? Right? That is something that, regardless of the person's interest, it's something they enjoy. So they're more likely to share with you. And when they're sharing things that they enjoy with you, they're more likely to walk away from the conversation as well, enjoying that. So that is the third piece there. You're also able to maybe establish some connections that you have, maybe some similar interests that you have in recreation. And that could lead to more of a bond developing from this first initial meeting, or continuing the relationship that you have. So we've got the F, O, the R, and the D. And the last thing is the dreams. What are your dreams? What are your end goals? If you had no work commitments and no commitments, what would you be doing with your life? Those are some great questions that really get people outside of the initial, as a conversation began, sort of regular, usual conversation topics that you talk about. But at the end of this conversation, the dreams piece, you really get to see what drives somebody. And that's really what I like about this kind of method. So we're talking about the Ford method here, how you can use it to have higher quality conversations, talking about family, talking about their occupation, talking about what they like to do in their recreational time. And then in the end, what really drives you? What are your dreams? So let me know what you think about this method. I hope that you can use it. Try using it this week and let me know down in the comments below how it helps you. Maybe you're somebody that loves small talk. Maybe you're somebody that really hates it. Either way, I believe this method is going to help you, really give you a strategy into having better quality conversation. So let me know about that. I really appreciate it. Hit the thumbs up button and go down and click subscribe for more great videos. Thanks for watching. Remember, choose greatness every day, and I'll see you next time.